Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we'll see if the new Photoshop AI generated fill will work to retouch or to smooth the skin of an image. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, let's go ahead and open Photoshop Beta, and then let's open the image from George Simon. Just drag it and open it in here, and then I will crop it a little bit to focus only in the face area, just like that, and one click on this check mark. Alright, now in this tutorial we're gonna see if the retouching will work with the AI. I don't think it's there yet, but we're gonna try it anyway. But we're gonna use the selection in a different way. We're gonna use actually the Q selection mode to make a selection of the skin, or try to make a selection of the skin. So let's press Q on our keyboard. And as you can see, if you are not familiar with the Q selection mode, it will allow you actually to use the brushes to make a selection. For example, as you can see in this layer, it changed to a blue color because I already have it set to blue. But if you want to change the color of the brush, you can just double click on this mask, and this allows you to change the options that you have in here. For example, we can change the color to, let's say, purple, and press OK. And I already have it, actually it's by default 50% opacity. And in here it's selected on masked area, and I'll press OK. Now we have to press Q again for us to enter the quick mask. Now we're gonna use the brushes to make a selection. I mean, I'm just gonna try to make a smooth selection of the face for us, maybe to have a better result when it comes to generating the skin. Alright, so I have the opacity set to like 70%. Or let's make it like 60. Yeah, let's make it 65. And then black is actually will make a selection. So I have my foreground color in here set to black. And I'm gonna start brushing the skin. I mean, if you have a stylus, you can switch to your stylus. It will be much better to control the brushing. So I'm just gonna try to make a very decent selection. I mean, even if you go outside of the face, I'm gonna fix that later, because I think it's very important to stay inside the face for the generative fill work better. I mean, I don't recommend to use this method to smooth or to retouch the skin, but I'm just gonna try it to see if it work or no. And you have to keep in mind that this is still in beta, so there is a lot of room of improvement in the future. I'm sure after 1 year or 6 months it will be much better to use this tool than now. Alright, so let's actually brush a little bit in the neck area and the shoulders. Alright, and let's make the brush a little bit smaller again, and let's select this area in here. Alright, now I'm gonna switch to white as my foreground color to remove all the places that I don't want. For example, this area in here, don't want to be included, and all these areas outside. And also I will want to make sure that the lips are not touched, because I think AI tend to create very weird lips. Let me zoom in a little bit and delete a little bit from the nose parts too, just like that. Let's see if we can keep these piercings. And also I want to make sure that the eyes are not touched too. All right, something like this. And also make sure that the eyelashes too, and the eyebrows too, both of them. So try to make a decent selection for us to have a good result. Let's hope. All right, now I'm gonna zoom out and I think it looks okay. So now I'm gonna press Q again to go outside of the quick selection, but I have to inverse this selection by pressing Ctrl Shift U. And I also want to include all this in here, so I'm just gonna use the lasso tool, and by pressing Shift I can add to the selection. So I'm gonna press Shift and I will make a circle on this, and this will add it, and a circle on this to add it. And I think we are ready to go. So let's try generative fill and let's type smooth skin and let's see, hit generate. Oh wow, this is actually way more weird than I thought it will be. Okay, I don't think it's recommended to use the generative fill to smooth the skin. This is actually pretty decent, but there is a lot of weird areas. So let's hit generate one more time and see. Maybe we'll have a better variation. Alright, so now I think we are getting even weird stuff. So let's hit generate again. Okay, so far I think this is the best one, but I don't like the way that it makes the lips actually a little bit more, you know, you can see a smile in here or something. But let's hit generate again one more time and see. Sometimes it's also help if you write a better prompt. Actually, this is actually pretty decent. I think we will go with this one. We need to make a little bit of changes when it comes to the nose, but pretty much I think it looks better than the other ones. As you can see, we generate 12 of them, but I think this is the best one so far. Yeah, I think we will stick with this one. And I also want actually to try to change the eyes. So let's go back to the quick selection tool and hit in B again, and let's make a selection of the eyes. I mean, I really like her eyes, but I just want to try to see if we get a very nice natural or like realistic color when it comes to the eyes. So let's see. Alright, so we have a selection, so I'm gonna press Q again and then Ctrl Shift I to inverse, or Command Shift I, and then let's hit generate and let's actually write green eyes or whatever color. I think I will keep it green for the green in the background, and I will hit generate. Oh wow, this is, doesn't look realistic at all, but I think the third one is the best one, even it doesn't look that realistic too. But I think I will go with it, or maybe I will generate one more try for the eyes. Wow, this is looking very weird, especially with the pupil. but I think it's still in beta, and I think it's okay when it comes to, I mean, I don't recommend to smooth the skin using the AI, but I just want to try and see how this will look. I mean, of course you can modify this, you can drop down the opacity a little bit, and you know, just delete a little bit of, because remember that this comes with the layer mask. If you are afraid that you're gonna use the, you're gonna lose the layer mask, you can just make a copy by pressing Alt or Option and drag it on top, and this will create a copy, and you can use the layer mask that you have in the layer, and the same brush we can delete from the parts that we want to go, or we want to take back from the original image. For example, this person, I want it to be here, and also I want this a little bit like this, and I don't think it looks bad. All these learners, I think I will bring them back just like that. And you can also try the blending option to blend this even more, but I think for this tutorial it looks pretty decent. And I want to bring back this necklace, even that it's a little bit blur, but it's good to have some details in here. That's a little bit, maybe I will make the brush even lower, and I will bring back. Alright, I think it's not bad at all. I always don't like this, I think I will keep it here. Alright, yeah, I think this is really nice, but of course it's not as professional. It looks a little bit fake, but there we go, we have a very nice smooth skin. So let's group everything together and see before and after. It's very different, but I think it's overall, it's a very nice smoothing. And there we go. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.